Hi everyone, in this video I'll show you how to read and write process memory of anti-cheat protected games. So let's start. We need some anti-cheat protected game first, and for example we can take RoboCraft. Let's run cheat engine. Cheat engine is very powerful tool, so why not to use it? Probably should. Yeah, we need to install Easy Anti-Cheat. The program ran, so we can open process. Open. And obviously we can't just bypass anti-cheat that easy. So the program is loaded, so let's try to... Oh, that's loud. I want to tune settings first. That's better. Yep. So let's try to read some value. Let's try to find some value. And we don't find anything, of course. So that's because Cheat Engine uses such routines as write process memory and read process memory, which are user mode routines. But we can change this behavior by selecting these boxes. So let's quit the game and select everything. I think okay, and we see the caption dbk64 loaded. So dbk64 is a kernel mode driver, so now we use kernel mode routines to read and write process memory. So let's do it. And isNTCheat detected that we use cheat engine, but previously it didn't. So we can say that it detected driver dbk64. It doesn't want us to load it. So let's close cheat engine and run RoboCraft. And it still says the cheat engine is open. So we need to run kernel module and loader. And now I think we can play RoboCraft. So yes, so Easy Anti-Cheat detects kernel mode driver but not cheat engine. So we need to do some work on kernel mode driver. And why Easy Anti-Cheat detects it is because it has signatures of this driver. This is a very popular driver, and we need to change it in order to Easy Anti-Cheat not to detect it. So let's do it. It took me a lot of time, but I did it. So the link to repository is in the description, probably. So this is my version of dbk64. And to compile it, you need to follow the instruction from README. It's very easy. So let's just compile it, just to show what to do. So I named it dbk64, just like original driver. I figured out that it doesn't detect that Easy Anti-Cheat doesn't detect it anyway. So we use test signature for this, and now we have this directory where we have these four files, and this driver is from Cheat Engine version 7.2, so we need not Cheat Engine 7.1 but 7.2, and we need to compile it from source. Or if you have trouble with this, you can download from link in the README. I compiled it. So there it is. Repository of Cheat Engine, but this is my repository. Binary directory. And all we need to do is copy these files here. And now we have what we could call undetected cheat engine, I guess. So now I'll just show that it works, and basically that's all. We'll use virtual machine because we'll have some troubles with loading this driver. So I'll use this one. Let's run it. Now we need some place where to place it. This is previous copy of Cheat Engine. So where is my virtual machine? This is it. Dist. Now this is, I think I can close it. So I select all files and just drag and drop it here, and I think I can close this. So I'll call this folder client. So let's run it. And we have some problems with loading this driver because it has test signature. And we can't load test sign driver very easy. So we need to use workaround, which is called dsifix. The li link is in the README. Open command prompt as administrator and cd root of c. Here we have this ifix, and when we run it, we'll have maybe a few hours, maybe a few minutes to play the game before we get blue screened. This is a little bit of problem, but not quite, because we still are able to read memory. So let's run it. So everything went well, no blue screen yet. And now we run 64 version of Easy Anti-Cheat. And we see dbk64 loaded. And now we need to run this command. You can find out what this command does by yourself, I think. So the driver is loaded. Let's run Steam. I can close this and I can close this. Let's just run. So as you can see, Easy Anti-Cheat allowed us to run game, run the game. So it wasn't detected. And now we can attach process. And let's test it. Let's scan. You can see it finds values. So you can use it just like for any other game, which maybe wasn't protected by anti-cheat. So now you can use multi-level pointers to create your cheats, but if you try to attach debugger, it froze, be probably because this is in virtual machine. Let's just run it again. Something went wrong. Something went terribly wrong. I think it's because of I run it in virtual machine. What I just wanted to do, I already forgot. Basically, yeah, now it works. Now we can read memory. And yes, we can use multi-level pointers, but yes, I wanted to attach debugger. So let's do it. Find out what writes. We usually want to find out something like this. And spoiler alert, it doesn't work.
It's supposed to be working. What the fuck?
But I think this is subject for another video as soon as I'll find out how to fix it. So yeah, I'll publish this driver in a repository so you can either download pre-compiled version or compile it yourself. Use whatever name you want. So usually when such drivers gets published, it gets detected by ISNT cheat because it develops signatures. But I think I can handle it. I can modify this driver dynamically so you can just recompile it and it won't be detected again. But I need to check it. And first I need for this driver to be detected. So you can use it for your own purposes. And so basically that's all. Thank you for watching.